Right. Well, today we're going to look at chapter 6.1, percents and decimals. This kind of leads us into our unit dealing with fractions, decimals, percents, and their relationship with each other. But today we're going to be focusing on just the percents and the decimals. So here is our key idea of this chapter. When writing percents as decimals, this is how you're going to do this. You're going to first remove the percent symbol. So let's just pretend that we have a number like 38%. Okay? So we start off by removing the percent symbol. So we're going to have just 38. And then it says divide by 100 or just move the decimal point two places to the left. Well, when we have a whole number like 38 for 38%, you will remember that the decimal goes right over here. It's to the right of it because that does not change the value of the number by having the decimal there. And so when we change a percent to a decimal, we're going to just move our decimal two places to the left, which leaves us with 0.38 or 38 hundredths, which is the same thing as 38%. Here's another example. We start off with 23%. We're going to move the decimal over two places, and now we're left with 0.23. I imagine many of you have learned this already at some point, so this should be a nice review for you to kind of ease you back in. So now we're going to look at some examples of how to change our percents to decimals. So for number one, example number one, part A, we're given 52% as a decimal. So we start off and we're going to write our 52% as a number without the percent sign. So we're just dropping the percent sign, giving us 52. Our decimal would start off to the right. And we're going to move it over two places, 1, 2, which gives us 0.52. And so that is the decimal value of 52%. And so the other part we're going to do is we're going to check it by using the model here to the right. We're going to use our base 10 model to help us here. So we're going to look and count up 52 squares. Now, each row or each column is 10 little blocks. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then I just have to count up these two, giving me 52. Hopefully that makes perfect sense to you. Let's look at our next problem here. We have 7%. So this one's a little bit different than we've seen. We're going to have the number 7. And again, our decimal is to the right of the 7. And we're going to move it over two places to the left. So we're going to go 1, 2. Now, this is where the new decimal point is right here. You'll notice we have a space. What do we do with that space? We're going to fill it in with a 0. So it's our final answer would be 0.07. And so 0.07, or 7 hundredths, is our decimal value for the percent. And we're just going to count out 7 little blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's all we have are these 7 little blocks here. All right, so we're going to move on to your first couple practice problems. I want you to go ahead and try 1 and 2. Once you've tried these two, you can check it with my work. And then if you feel good about that, you can move on to number 3 and 4. All right, so go ahead and take a moment to see how you do on this. All right, let's check to see how you guys did here. So we're going to start off by writing our 24% just as 24. And I'm going to put my decimal to the right of the 4. That way you have 24 as a whole number. And then I'm going to move my decimal over 1, 2 places to the left, giving me 0.24. So that is my final answer for the decimal. We're going to go ahead and color in our base 10 model next. And then with a little magic, we have our base model filled in with 24 squares filled in to represent our answer. Let's go ahead and look at our next number. We start off with 3%, so we're going to start off by writing it as 3. And I'm going to go ahead and put my decimal here to the right. I'm going to move this over 2 spots to the left. So 1, 2. So that new decimal is right there. And I'm going to go ahead and fill it in with a 0 here. So I have 0.03. Just so we are perfectly clear with each other, if you get to be pretty comfortable with this, you don't have to show the work of moving the decimal over. Now, if you end up making mistakes after mistakes, you really should do that. But if you can look at 24% and know that you move it over 2 places, I'm perfectly fine with it. It's pretty easy. Okay, so let's go ahead and fill in our squares for the 3%. This one's a pretty easy one. We're going to do 1, 2, 3. So that represents the 3 squares for 3%. All right, let's go ahead and look at our next set of problems. 3 and 4, why don't you give those a try, and we'll catch up with you in a moment. Okay, well, these problems were a little bit different than what you've seen before. We'll see how you did. If you struggled with it, not a big deal. You can just see what I did. Maybe you got them right. We'll see. So we start off with 107%. We write it as 107. I'm going to put my decimal here to the right of the 7, because this is a whole number. I'm going to move it over 2 places. So now I have 1.07. That is my decimal value. So let me go ahead and color in our model to represent our final answer. Okay, so yeah, I know it's a little sloppy, but that's how it looks on the old iPad. So I've colored in one full block because we have 1.07. So 100 little squares needs to be filled out. Plus, we're going to do an additional 7 more squares. So we're going to go ahead and fill in our additional 7 squares. Giving us a grand total of 107 squares filled in to represent our decimal and our percent. So let's go ahead and try our next problem, number 4. So we have 92.7. Now I know this is a little bit different, mainly because we already have a decimal in here, which actually makes it easier, because now we just have to move the decimal over 1, 2 spots, and we get 0.927. That is our decimal value. Pretty easy, huh? Let's go ahead and fill this in. Okay, just about done. I know it's a little bit of a hassle having to color in all these little squares. However, it is really important that you understand how to represent your decimal and your percent with a model, okay? So, look, we have 9 rows or 9 columns already filled up. So it gives us 90, but we need 92.7%. So I'm going to fill in another 2, which gets us up to the 92. And then, let's think about, what do we do after that? Well, we're not going to do an entire third square, because that'd be 93, but we're going to do something really close. We're going to go to about maybe, that'd be perfect, but it's easier for you, I'm sure, than me. But you're going to go to an almost, like, 70% of a square. So you're going to go almost all the way to a little bit past the halfway mark of that third square to represent the 0.7%. Okay? All right, hopefully this made perfect sense for you. We're going to move on. Okay, so our next key idea is going to be doing the opposite. Now we're going to start off with decimals, and we're going to write them as percents. So prior to this, we were just moving our decimal from the right to the left. Well, now we're going to take our decimal that's on the left and move it to the right. Just move it the opposite direction, and we're going to move the decimal 2 places. So, for example, let's say that I have 0.05 as my decimal. I'm just going to take the decimal, I'm going to move it over one, two spots, giving me 5. I'm going to add my percent, which represents, I like to think of it, I'm moving my decimal over two places since there's 2 points on the percent sign, an easy way to remember. But I'd rewrite it that way. The same thing over here. I start off with 0.36. I'm going to move the decimal over two places, leaving me with 36%. So let's look at example two and see how this works. So we have 0.47 as a percent, just like here. We're going to move our decimal over two spaces to the right, and then we end up with 47%. And for B, we start off with 0.663%. So we're starting off right here. We're going to move our decimal over two spaces to the right, and we end up with 66.3%. Okay, so for part C, we start off with 1.8. We're going to move our decimal over two places to the right, and we end up with 180%. So as we can tell here, just to point out, I don't know if you've noticed this or not, but when your decimal is less than 100, is less than 1, your percent is less than 100. When your decimal is over 1, like it was here for C, your decimal or your percent is over 100, because 1 or 1.0 or whatever you want to do, 1.00, this is the same thing as 100%. So if it's less than 1, it's less than 100%. If it's greater than 1, it's over 100%. So just something I want to point out. I was thinking about that while you're doing we're doing the last problem here. Okay, so let's look at letter D. We start off with 0.009, so we write that down. Move our decimal over two places to the right, giving us 0.9. So we have 0.9%. Okay. If you could, go ahead and give 5 and 6 a try, and then once you have done each one, go ahead and fill out your model, and we'll see how you did. Okay, so for number 5, we have 0.94. So I have 0.94. Going to move the decimal over two places to the right, 1. 2. So now I have 94%. Go ahead and write this down as a in my model. So let's go ahead and do this. Okay. So we're at 90, and then we're going to do 4 more to give us 94%. Just like right here. All right, there's 94%. Let's go ahead and try our next one. So we start off with 1.2, and we're changing this to a percent, so we need to move it over to the right two places. 1, 2. Can fill this in with a 0 right here. So I end up getting 120%. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and fill out our model. And your model should end up looking like this. We have one full base 10 filled for the 100%, and then two more of the columns give us the 20%, so 120%. Okay, let's go ahead and see how you did on the next set of problems. So go ahead at this time and try 7 and 8. I'll get back to you in just a moment. Okay, so we have 0.316. We're going to move this over two spaces to the right, giving us 31.6. This is just percent. This is very much like the problems we did before. Now that we have a partial percent, we're going to do a partial square when we do the model and see how that turned out. Okay, so we have 30 are three of the lines filled in. So 30%, we'll go ahead and do another one. Here's 31%. And then again, somewhere around the halfway mark, a little over the halfway mark, we'll fill that part in to represent that it's, 31.6%. Okay. Let's go ahead and try number eight. On this problem, we have 0.005. Going to move our decimal over two spaces to the right, giving us 0.5%. So when we graph this, it's going to be just a half of a square. Just a half of a square will get filled in. Something like that. And that's all we do here. Let's go ahead and move on. We're going to look at the example number three now. Here we have down writing a fraction as a percent and a decimal. Okay, so we're looking at this problem. It says, on a math test, you get 92 out of a possible 100 points. Which of the following is not another way of expressing 92 out of 100? Well, we can write this as a ratio to begin with. We can say 92 out of 100. And this would simplify to what? 46 out of 50. And that would simplify to 23 out of 25. That would be the fraction equivalence. Then I can write it as a decimal. If I have 92 out of 100, that's the same thing as, I'll do the percent first. It's like 92%, right? 92 out of 100, 92 per cent. And again, the percent is short for per century, 100 century. So percent, and so that's per 100. So we have 92%. And if we know it's 92%, then we know that it would be 0.92 as the decimal. So let's look to see what our choices are. We know that it's 23 out of 25. We know that it's 92%. Don't know about C. I have a pretty good idea, though. We know that it's 0.92. So, 23 over 25 is in simplest form, so it cannot be C. So C must be the only way of not expressing 92 out of 100. Okay? Now, for example 4 and the next few problems we're going to run across, this is going to be in the bonus sheet that you should have received. It was not in the packet. You could staple it to the back of your packet and just go there. I apologize. I didn't catch it till too late. So let's go ahead and take a look at these. So it says, the figure shows the portions of ultraviolet UV rays reflected by four different surfaces. You can see we have grass, sand, seafoam, and water. How many times more UV rays are reflected by water than seafoam? So it's already telling us that you're going to have more UV rays reflected by water than seafoam. They want to know how many times more, okay? So for the seafoam, we know that's 25%, which is the same thing as 25 over 100, which is the same. If you divide them both by 25, it's the same thing as 1/4. So that's one part. That is the seafoam. So we'll put SF for seafoam. And then I have the water, which is 21 over 25. So I have water, which is 21 over 25. Now, if I know that the water is more than the seafoam, I can show how many times bigger it is by doing division. So I'm going to take the 21 25ths. I'm going to divide it by 1/4. And that is the same thing as doing 21 over 25 times 4 over 1. We can't simplify this at all, so we get 84 over 25. And 25 goes into 84 three times, 75. So we have 3, and we're left with 9. So 9 over 25. Now, the way it shows you in the example here is they change them both to decimals, which you could do as well. I really don't care which way you do it. We do it as decimals. We do 0.25 right here. We change the decimal into, we have 21 over 25. We change that to 84 over 100, which you can see right over here, which is 0.84. And then we go ahead and divide it, and we get 3.36. So the water reflects about 3.4 more UV rays than seafoam. Or you could say about 3 9/25 times more UV rays than seafoam. Okay? So let's go ahead and look over here. You have it on your own. Why don't you go ahead and try number 9? And then number 10 is the other on your own, and then that will be it. We'll be done. So why don't you go ahead and give these a try? Okay, let's see how you did on this problem over here. It says write 18 out of 100 as a percent, as a fraction, and as a decimal. So 18 out of 100 is a ratio of 18 over 100, which is the same thing as 9 over 50. That's as simplified as that can get. Then 18 over 100 is the same thing as 18%. So there's your percent. And 18% is the same thing as 0.18 as a decimal. So that's how you'd write 18 out of 100 as a percent, a fraction, and as a decimal. On to this problem. Okay, so it says in example 4. How many times more UV rays are reflected by water than by sand? So we're looking at water and sand. So for, again, the water, as we can already tell, is going to be bigger than the sand. So we're going to have to divide the water by the sand. So we have 21 over 25, which is the same thing as 84 over 100, which if you want to, you could make this as a decimal and just make this 0.84. Again, this is for the water. Now for the sand, we have 0.15. And if you like, you can go ahead and divide. So we'll do 0.84 divided by 0.15. You must divide by a whole number, so I'm going to make this whole. Do the same thing over here as far as moving the decimal over. So move it over two spaces, just like I did with the 0.15. 15 goes into 84. Let's see. Goes in 15, 30, 45, 60, 75 goes in 5 times, which is 75. And then we can subtract it. 84 minus 75 is 9. Add a 0. Bring it down. 75 plus one more 15 is 90, so it's a 6. So we have minus 90. So our final answer would be water reflects Water reflects 5.6 times more more UV rays than sand. All right, well, hopefully this made some sense to you. That about wraps it up for us, so we'll get back to you here on our next lesson, which will be comparing ordering fractions, decimals, and percents.